الواحد أمين نبوات الساعة الحادي عشر من يوم الجمعة العظيمة من بسخة المقدسة التي مخلصنا الصالح بركاته علينا أمين.
Evolchen bizoxozos in te Moisis bia prophetis ere beves mois o apsho biniman amin evgoemo os bije apsho in se Moisis nem aaron chem bikain kemi ev emos je bai vot vai taerin avot in te rombi Sajinim tasgogis en tenish viri em Bisrael evgemos. Ua u en tetries is oa benoti. Shaininim shainin teni eneti ro amin.
من سفر الخروج لموسى النبي بركاته علينا أمين. وكلم الرب موسى وهارون في أرض مصر قائلا إن هذا الشهر يكون لكم رأس الشهور فاجعلوه أول الشهور السنة. كلم كل جماعة بني إسرائيل وقول لهم في اليوم العاشر من الشهر فليأخذ كل واحد له خروفا بحسب بيوت أبائهم خروفا لكل بيت، وإن كان أهل البيت القليلين لا يكفون لخروف فليأخذ هو وجاره القريب من بيته بحسب عدد النفوس كل واحد على قدر ما يكفيه من الخروف، وليكن لكم خروفا ذكرا صحيحا ابن السنة تأخذونه من الحملان أو من الجداء، ويكون عندكم تحت الحفظ إلى اليوم الرابع عشر من الشهر، وليسبحه كل جمهور جماعة بني إسرائيل ووقت المساء، ويأخذون من دمه ويضعون على القائمتين والعتبتين في كل البيوت التي يأكلون فيه، ويأكلون اللحم في هذه الليلة مشويا بالنار مع فطير من أعشاب مرة يأكلونه، لا تأكلوا نيئا أو مطبوخا بالماء بل مشويا بالنار مع رأسه وأكراعه وما في جوفه، ولا تبقوا منه شيئا للصباح، وعظمه منه لا تكسروا، والباقي منه إلى الغد تحرقونه بالنار، وهكذا تأكلونه وأحقاؤكم مشدودة وأحذيتكم في أرجلكم وعصياكم في أيديكم، وتأكلون بسرعة لأنه فصح للرب، وسأجتاز في أرض مصر في هذه الليلة وأضرب كل بكر في أرض مصر من الإنسان إلى البهيمة، وسأصنع انتقاما بكل آلهة المصريين أنا الرب، ويكون الدم علامة على البيوت التي أنتم فيها، فأرى الدم وأسطر عليكم ولا يكون فيكم ضرب للهلاك حينما أضرب كل أبكار الأرض أرض مصر، ويكون لكم هذا اليوم تذكارا فتعيدون عيد للرب في أجيالكم، تعيدون فريضة أبدية مجدا للثالوث القدوس.
The prophecy from the book of Leviticus, may its blessings be with us, amen. In the first month, on the 14th day of the month, between the evening times and the Lord's Passover, and on the 15th day of this month, and the Feast of Unleavened Bread to the Lord, 7 days shall you eat unleavened bread. And the first day shall be a holy convocation to you. You shall do no customary work, and you shall offer whole burnt offerings to the Lord 7 days. And the seventh day shall be a holy convocation to you. You shall do no customary work. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, and you shall say to them, When you shall enter into the land which I give you, and reap the harvest of it, then shall you bring a sheaf, the first fruits of your harvest, to the priest, and he shall lift up the sheaf before the Lord to be accepted for you. On the morning of the first day, the priest shall lift it up, and you shall offer to the day on which you bring the sheaf a lamb without blemish of a year old for a whole burnt offering to the Lord. Glory be to the Holy Trinity. Amen.
Athanasius, the apostolic, may his blessing be with us all. Amen. It is written in the scriptures, if our souls are following the law of God, the powers of darkness will not overpower us. If we drift away from God, they will rule over us. Brethren who want to be saved, teach yourselves to float in the depth of God's richness and wisdom. Stretch your arms in the form of the cross to cross the great sea of this life and to go to God. The hindering doubts are for those who live away from the commands of the universal church. I mean the disbelief, adultery, evil report, and love of money that is the root of all evils. The sign of the cross is spread over the creation. If the sun does not emit its rays, it cannot glow, neither would the moon light. The birds in the sky, if they do not stretch out their wings, they cannot fly. Neither can the ships leave port if they do not unfold their sails. The same happened with Moses, the arch prophet. When Moses held up his arms, he defeated Amalek. Daniel was saved from the lion's den and Jonah from the fish's belly. Tekla, when they threw her to the lions, she was saved by the sign of the cross. Also Susanna from the hands of the two old men. Judith from the whole furnace, and the three young men from the burning fiery furnace. All those were saved by the sign of the cross. It was also said, let your dwelling be in one place, that is the church, to be nourished by the words of the scriptures and by the heavenly bread and blood of Christ, and to be comforted all time by the word of God. We conclude the homily of our Holy Father, Abba Athanasius Apostolic, who enlightened our minds and our hearts, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
رسالة بولس الرسول إلى أهل غلاطيا بركاته على جميعنا أمين. أنتم الذين قد رسم أمام أعينكم يسوع المسيح مصلوبا، أريد أن أعرف منكم هذا فقط، أبأعمال الناموس أخذتم الروح أم بخبر الإيمان؟ أهكذا أنتم أغبياء؟ أبعدما تأتون بالروح تكملون الآن بالجسد؟ أهكذا قد احتملتم تعبا كثيرا عبثا إن كان عبثا؟ فالذي يمنحكم الروح ويعمل قوات فيكم أبأعمال الناموس أم بخبر الإيمان؟ كما آمن إبراهيم فحسب له برا، نعمة الله الآب تحل على أرواحنا جميعا.
شوي سنين أنا اللي راخي نفراني مبيوت نمبشيري نمببن مسوا بنوتن الدكسة بتري كي وكي أقبن ماتي كنين كي كستوسي ونصوني ونن أمين. تسبحة صلاة الساعة 11 من البسخة المقدسة التي مخلصنا الصالح. أبانا الذي في السماوات، الجمعة العظيمة كريا ليسون توم
تاتي قوم نمبي ونمبي اسمو نمبي اما شايني امين امانويل بنوتي بنورو سوك تاتي قوم نمبي ونمبي اسمو نمبي اما شايني امين بشوي سيسوس بخريستو بسو تيرن آغاسوس تاغو نمبا ازمو بيب شوي سيف شو بيني سو تيريا إف أوه سوك تاتي قوم نمبيو نمبي اسمو نمبي آماي شاين أمين
يا ليسون سوك تاتي قوم نمبيو نمبي اسمو نمبي آماي شاين أمين إمانويل بن نوتي بن أورو سوك تاتي قوم نمبيو نمبي اسمو نمبي آماي شاين أمين بشوي سيسوس بخريستوس بسو تيرن آغاثوس تاغوم نمبا إزمو بيب شوي سف شو بيني سو تيريا إذ أوه Coptic gom nembion embismon embiama shainem
in yeleison coptic gom nembion embismon embiama shainem in Emmanuel ben noti ben oro Soktet igom nimbio nimbismon nimbiama shayne min beshoin si sos be Christos besutir nagasos tagom nimba ezmo bebshoin sev shobini sotiriya efowe Soktet igom nimbio nimbismon nimbiama
Shaine amin Emmanuel ben noti ben oro Thokteti gom nembio nembesmo nembiama Shaine amin besho isiso Be Christos besutir nagatho Tagom nemba esmo bi efchoi sefcho bini Sotiria ef oweb Thokteti gom nembio nembesmo nembiama Shaine amin
Yeleison soktet igom nembio nembesmon nembiama Shaine amin Emmanuel ben noti ben oro Soktet igom nembio nembesmon nembiama Shaine amin besho sisos be Christos Besutir nagasos tago Nimba esmu bif shoysif shubini Sutiriya ef owe Sukteti gom nimbio Nimbismu nimbiyama Shaini amin
Yeleison tukteti gom nimbio Nimbismu nimbiyama Shaini amin Menu ilpen noti pen oro Tukteti gom nimbio Nembezmon el mai shaine min beshois Jesus be Christo besotir en agatho
Tetigom nembio nembesmo nembiama shaine mi
Shopini
ef so diria ef o ef. Tok te tigom nem dio, nem bismo, nem dia
ama shayne amin menu it benoti ben oro Thok teti gom nem bi o nem bezmonem bi ama shayne amin bechoy si sos be Christos Resultir in agathos tagom nem baizmo bi efchoy sefcho bi ne efsotireia ef owe Thok teti gom nem bi o nem bezmonem bi ama shayne amin
Giriele son za
أبانا الذي في السماوات
Oh,
Exeus in mestri sacros iostrag evangelio, Kyrion ketos ion emon, Ekatev somen sophia orteako somen, Togio evangelio.
Angelionis uwab kata matsionagiyu.
Spicata betas mainte pierfi affugi, es genepsoi ebipsit af eresnav, o picahi af monmen, ni petra affugi, o ni emhaf avu. Mission soma in tenies oeb nit af kut af tu unu ustem bi evangelionis oeb kata markun agiu. Bikata etzma in te birefi of gov jechenes nav yes jeneb shoy egri eten of the enjebekte ton tarchos worship evangelionet
looks
tam loken ageo. Etavnav zenje bikantora chose vietavshobi avto emefnoti evgoemos. Je ontos neoethmi bibaeromi, o nimishtiro etavigenti artheria, etavanaveni etavshobi. Aftas to ke horchen to mesetenit, na uide erato eve owen gene fremen so un tiro, ne han ki omini et av moshi en sov, ez je. E, ti Galilea in avna yoshtem bevangelionezo kanta yo enna geyo
Επειδή νιέτ παρεσκευή ειδέ, ειναν το στιμό ειντζε, νίσο μαϊτζεν πιεσταυρός, εμέ ψαβατόν, νί, ειονιστή, αρπή πιχώ, εμπα σαβατόν, ετέμα βαφτιό επιλατός, ίνα εν τέκο, σωστέμ πεφαγγελιονέθ, ο εβδοξάς.
من مزامير أبينا داود النبي بركاته علينا أمين بسطت يدي إليك فاستجب لي يا رب عاجلا فقد فنيت روحي لا تصرف وجهك عني فأشابه الهابطين في الجب هللويا في يديك أستودع روحي ولقد فديتني أيها الرب إله الحق هللويا ليتراءى الله علينا ويرحمنا ويجعلنا مستحقين لسماع الإنجيل المقدس فصل من إنجيل معلمنا ماري متى بركاته علينا آمين وإذا حجاب الهيكل قد انشق إلى اثنين من فوق إلى أسفل والأرض تزعزعت والصخور تشققت والقبور تفتحت وقام كثير من أجساد القديسين الراقدين وخرجوا من القبور بعد قيامته ودخلوا المدينة المقدسة وظهروا لكثيرين وأما قائد المئة والذين كانوا معه يحرسون يسوع فلما رأوا الزلزلة وما كانا خافوا جدا وقالوا حقا هذا هو ابن الله وكانت هناك نساء كثيرات ينظرن من بعيد وهن اللواتي كنا تبعن يسوع من الجليل يخدمنه وبينهم مريم المجدلية ومريم أم يعقوب وأم يوسي وأم ابنا زبادي
Gospel according to Saint Mark. May his blessings be with us all. Amen. And the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom. And when the centurion was stood up over against him, saw that he so cried out and gave up the ghost, he said, Truly, this man was the Son of God. There were also women looking on afar off, among whom was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James, the less and of the Josephs, and Salome, who also, when he was in Galilee, followed him and ministered unto him. And many other women which came up with him unto Jerusalem.
Glory be to God forever.
وأيضا من إنجيل معلمنا ماري لوقا البشير بركته المقدسة فلتكن مع جميعنا أمين.
ولما رأى قائد المئة ما حدث مجد الله قائلا: بالحقيقة كان هذا الإنسان بارا. وكل الجموع الذين أتوا لهذا المنظر لما عاينوا ما حدث رجعوا وهم يقرعون صدورهم. وكان جميع ما عرفه والنسوة اللواتي كن يتبعنه من الجليل واقفين من بعيد ينظرون ذلك. والمجد لله دائما.
والمجد لله دائما.
We beseech our Lord and God that we may be worthy to hear the holy and divine gospel. A reading from the holy gospel according to Saint John. May his blessings be with us all. Amen. The Jews therefore, because it was the preparation that the body should not remain upon the cross on the Sabbath day, for that Sabbath day was a high day, besought Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. Then came the soldiers and brake the legs of the first and of the other which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was dead already, they broke not his legs, but one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, and forthwith came there out blood and water. And he saw it bear record, and his record is true. And he knows that he says true, that ye might believe. For these things were done, that the scripture should be fulfilled: a bone of him shall not be broken. And again another scripture says, they shall look on him who they pierced him.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. In the book of Isaiah, the prophecy about our Lord Jesus Christ that his name is going to be called Emmanuel. Emmanuel, which means God with us. Before his departure from earth, before his ascension to heaven, he told his disciples, I am with you to the end of the earth. He had been revealed to us. The hidden mystery that was foreordained for us. Before the beginning of creation for the glory of mankind, as St. Paul said in 1 Corinthians. Now we see it. Now we can know and perceive for sure that he is with us. That's why the wise church had intended to put that beautiful title of Christ in the doxology of the Pascha week: Emmanuel, our God and our King. And while he was with us on earth for those 3.5 years preaching the kingdom of God, he had revealed his Godhead, his power, his majesty. Lots of people came to him. while he was, and he is. Lots of people come in contact with him. And our Lord Jesus Christ was and is for the blessing of some, and God forbid, for the curse of others. He is there to sublime those who believe in him and love him, and those who don't will by their own will put down. We're going to go through some events of today and see how this is applicable. The first event that we're going to see today is during the interrogation of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Jews seized him in Garden of Gethsemane, and they brought him to Caiaphas, where they passed upon him a condemnation of death for a false reason. And they took him to Pontius Pilate because they wanted the sentence that they have passed to be executed by the government. Pontius Pilate resented for a while. He didn't want to kill Christ because he thought he is a righteous man. He had done no wrong. But we don't want to discuss Pontius Pilate a lot. But when Pontius Pilate heard that he is from Galilee, the country was governed by Herod, and Herod was there in Jerusalem that day, he sent him to Herod. Our teacher, St. Luke, in his Gospel chapter 22, he said a beautiful story about that. He said that Herod, for a long time, had longed to see Christ. He wanted to see him and see some of his miracles that he used to do. He wanted to see Christ for a long reason. He wanted to see the fantasy that Christ will do. He wants to see some miracles. So Christ was brought to Herod. And Herod asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews? You said so." He replied. He asked him so many other questions. But our Lord Jesus Christ, knowing the heart of Herod, he ceased to speak. He didn't want to open his mouth. And Herod made fun of him. He put on him a gorgeous array, and he started to mock him and the soldiers and the high priests around him. Christ was there for Herod, but Herod could not take the blessing of Christ. Too bad. Herod was there to be delighted with the presence of Christ and the presence of some miracles to entertain himself. But he was not looking for the actual blessings of Christ being in his own presence. He arrayed him with gorgeous dress and made fun of him. And then he sent him back to Pontius Pilate. But do you think this event is going to just pass? No. No. The presence of Christ in his palace had brought curse on him and his palace, because he could not comprehend what he is standing up in front of. God is with us. A few years later, and we hear that story in the book of Acts, chapter 12. The people of Tyre wanted to make a reconciliation with Herod because they were eating out of his territory. And they took an appointment to meet with Herod. And Herod put on himself the royal apparel. And he went out to meet the Tyre people. Listen to what the book of Acts document. When the Tyre people saw Herod and they wanted to please him, he is a man to be pleased by vain words. So they started to talk to him, "Oh, you are like a god." And he did not give glory to God. What happened to him? The man that mocked Christ, heaven mocked him. Because instantly, we read that the angel of God struck him and the worms ate him alive. He put a gorgeous apparel on Christ and mocked him. And the heaven mocked his gorgeous royal apparel and took the glory from him. Emmanuel, our God, he's with us. Will you be blessed of him? Or, God forbid, cursed because you did not consider his presence? On the other hand, we see Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus that wanted it also, he was longing to see Christ. And Christ was passing through the streets of Jericho. And Zacchaeus was of a short stature. And he could not see him, Christ, because of his little stature. So he climbed the sycamore tree. We have two people here. Herod, he was longing to see Christ. And Zacchaeus, who also longed to see Christ. And Christ, knowing the heart of Zacchaeus, stood under the sycamore tree, lift up his eye to Zacchaeus on the top of the sycamore tree and tell him, Zacchaeus, come down. I must be in your house today. Emmanuel, God is with us. He had been in the house of Zacchaeus, and he had not left the house of Zacchaeus before he said this. Salvation had happened to this house because it is the son of Abraham. Emmanuel was at the house of Herod, and Emmanuel was at the house of Zacchaeus, but a great difference there is. Is Emmanuel in your house? Is your house blessed or otherwise, God forbid, cursed? Do you consider, do you love, do you offer Zacchaeus? He said, half of my goods to the poor. And if I have oppressed anyone, I will repay him fourfold. Zacchaeus was a great man. Do you know what the law of the Jews said about that? If you oppress somebody, you give him what you oppress him plus one-fifth of what you have oppressed. He said, I am going to repay him fourfold. 400% over what the law had said. Why? Because he was filled with the presence of the Lord. Emmanuel, our Lord, he was there with his disciples. He was there with the one that he loved so much. The Bible witnessed to that in the book of St. John several times, that our Lord Jesus Christ had loved St. John. He loved all, but St. John a little bit more. And St. John did not leave Christ in the darkest time of his life. He's the only one apostle that went all the way to the cross. He's the only one disciple that was standing down the cross. It's a love that works. It's a love that is rewarded also. Because of the gift of love that St. John had in his heart, he was added on. And that what the Bible say? Whoever have it will be added unto him. Whoever does not have it, even what he has, it will be taken away from him. And that what the Bible says? Because he had the love to our Lord Jesus Christ that much, our our Lord Jesus Christ on the cross looks at him and said, John, this is your mother. He added unto him the most precious gift that could be given to a human, Saint Virgin Mary, to dwell in his house and to live with him and to care for him, not him to care for him. Because with her prayers and with his intercession, she will lift him up to heaven. But John, this is your mother. Woman, this is your son. It's a gift of love that has been added unto Saint John. On the other hand, we see Judas Iscariot, one of the disciples, no different. Actually, he had a gift too. He was given the money issue. He was instructed to keep the money for the group. He was entrusted with the expenses. He had a gift. Christ trusted him. He knew beforehand. But he left it to his own free will, whether to do good with it or to do bad with it. He does that all the time. He leaves it to us. And we write our own destiny. We write our own destiny. When he said, I am going to go and prepare a place for you, when I prepare the place, I will come back, so I will take you to me, so wherever I am, you will be also. Christ went up to prepare a place for us, whereby we are going to put every brick in that house with our own hands, with our own free will. What happened to Judas Iscariot? He betrayed Christ. Whatever he had, he lost it all. He lost the gift that Christ had given him. And he lost even up to his soul. Because he hung himself dead. And Christ said, I wish this man had never been even born. Emmanuel, God with us, that had given us gifts, so do we trade in it and give it to God to build a house for us in heaven? Or, God forbid, we lose it all and we go to dust. Emmanuel, he was on the cross, and there was a right thief on his right hand. A thief that has not seen miracles of Christ, had only seen his agony and his pain, and he has only seen the most weak of his life, the weakness of Christ on the cross. but he had also seen the righteousness of Christ. He had heard that he had done nothing wrong. And he looked upon himself, the right thief looked upon himself and saw his own corruption, his own sin, his own worthiness of being dead on the cross, and recognized that. Emmanuel, when God was besides him, he shone upon him the righteousness that declared to him his filth. And he did not abstain to proclaim, "I am a sinner." Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And he rebuked the left one. This man had done no evil. Aren't you afraid of God? This man had done no evil. We are worthy of what we have done. When he recognized his sin, he took the reward of repentance, just like the publican and the Pharisees, that they went both together to the temple. And the publican stood at the end of the hall and said, "Lord, I'm not worthy. I'm a sinner." And the Pharisee said, "Thank you, Lord, because I pay my tithes. I fast 2 days a week. And I am more righteous than this sinner." And our Lord Jesus Christ witnessed, saying that this tax collector went into his house more righteous than the other one. On the other hand, we see a great man that have seen it all, that walked in the water, that saw the glory of God in Mount Tabor. And he was the only one that said, "It's good, O Lord, to be here. So we do 3 tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He had seen what no man had seen. The right thief proclaimed, Saint Peter denied. Thank God, because Christ had mercy on Peter and he looked at him while he was interrogated at the high priest's house, and he sent him a glimpse of love that touched his heart, and he wept bitterly and he was accepted. But on the other hand, there is a left thief that, seeing all this, seeing the sun goes down, seeing the light disdained, seeing that the earth quakes, could not repent. Even Christ was right by him. Believe me, if that left thief had repented, even Christ had given up the spirit, he would be forgiven, but he didn't. Because the centurion, after Christ had passed away in flesh, he said, this man was really the Son of God. And according to the paradise of the Father, this centurion was one of the martyrs for the sake of Christ. Emmanuel. Emmanuel. God is with us. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's with us now, and he's with us forever. But where are you and I from him? That would make the difference. Wish in that beautiful season that we grow closer, loving, appreciating, so we will get the blessings of Christ being with us. Glory be to him forever and ever. Amen.
Position of the 11th hour of Good Friday of the Holy Pascha of our good Savior. May blessing be with us all. Amen.
O Israel, the captive of his sons, look at how the Gentile centurion confessed the divinity of the crucified. Not only him, but all those around exclaimed with him, saying, truly this was the Son of God. Also, the thief of the right knew his power and asked for his mercy when he saw the wall of the altar rent, the sun occulted and the moon eclipsed. The earth shook, the rooks split, the stars fell to the earth, the tombs opened, the dead resurrected and went to town, and many recognized them. When they saw that, they acknowledged the power of the crucified, but Israel was blinded. It could not see, nor could comprehend. Because of the Sabbath, the bodies should not be left on wood. Thus, they asked the governor to break their knees so that they die. They broke those of the two thieves, but the Savior was already dead. One of the soldiers pierced him with a spear in his right side. Out of his side came blood and water simultaneously. The truthful witness saw that, and his testimony is true. Thus the prophecies were fulfilled, that none of his bones will be broken. It is also written, he will judge those who stabbed him. The centurion went home mystified and glorifying the Lord. With his suffering, Jesus the Savior granted the world eternal salvation.
Christ our Savior has come in his born suffering, that through his passion he may save us. Let us glorify and exalt his name, for he has done us great mercy according to his great mercy.
Christus Oh. اطلبوا لك يرحمنا الله ويترافع علينا ويسمعنا ويعيننا ويقبل سؤالات وطلبات قديسيه منهم بالصلاح عنا في كل حين ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us beseech God for the peace of the one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church and God's salvation and comfort in all places and to forgive us our sins.
اطلبوا وانا بين اخواتنا المرضى بكل الامراض في هذا الموضع وكل مكان لكي نعمل لنا الرب الهنا ويوم بالعافيه والشفاء ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for our fathers and brothers who are traveling and those who intend to travel in all places. May God aid their ways. Those who are traveling by seas, rivers, lakes, by ways or other means, may the Lord our God guide them, bring them back in safety and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن أهوية السماء وثمرات الأرض وكل الأشجار والكروم وكل شجرة مثمرة في جميع المسكونة لكي يباركها الرب إلهنا ويكملها بسلام ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask that God may grant us mercy before the sovereign rulers, incline their hearts with goodness towards us at all times and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا على ابانا واخواتنا الذين رقدوا وتنيحوا في الايمان بالمسيح منذ البات اباؤنا البطاركه وابانا المطارنه وابانا الاساقفه وابانا القمامسه وابانا القسوس واخوتنا الشمامسه وابانا الرهبان واخوتنا العلمانيين وعن كل الذين تنيحوا من المسيحيين لكي ينيح الرب الهنا نفوسهم اجمعين ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for those who attend the offerings of oblation, the one of the oil, the oil, the incense, the coverings of the altar, the books of prayers, and the vessels of the altar, that Christ our God may reward them in heavenly Jerusalem and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن موعوظي شعبنا لكي يباركهم الرب ويفتح عيون قلوبهم ويثبتهم على الإيمان الأرثوذكسي للنفس الأخير ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for this holy church and all Orthodox churches, the desert monasteries, the elders dwelling therein, and for the peace of the whole world, that the Lord may protect us and them from all evil and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن نياح نفس أبينا المكرم رئيس الأساقفة باب البطريرك الأنبا شنود الثالث. صلوا واطلبوا عن أبينا الأسقف المكرم الأنبا سرابي لكي يثبته الرب على كرسي سنين عديدة وأزمنة سالمة هادئة مديدة ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for our Orthodox fathers, metropolitans, bishops, and every place, proto-priests, priests and deacons, and all the orders of the church, that Christ our Lord may keep them, strengthen them, and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن اجتماعنا هذا وكل اجتماع الشعوب الأرثوذكسيين لكي يباركهم الرب إلهنا ويكملهم بسلام ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for all the hierarchies of the Holy Church and all the orders of the clergy, that the Lord our God may bless and support them and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن كل نفس لا تعب في الكنيسة المقدسة وما الشعب الأرثوذكسي لكي يصنع الرب إلهنا معهم رحمة ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for all Christ loving rulers who ask us to remember them in our prayers, that the Lord God may bless and remember them in his mercy and grant them favor before powerful rulers and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن المساكين والفلاحين والضعفاء وعن كل نفس متضايقة بكل نوع لكي يتراف علينا الرب إلهنا وإياهم ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for those who are in the distress of prisons, dungeons, captivity or exile, and those who are afflicted by devils, that the Lord our God may loosen their burdens, them from their burdens, and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن كل النفوس المجتمعة معنا اليوم في هذا الموضع يطلبون الرحمة لنفوسهم لكي تدركنا مراحم الرب إلهنا وإياهم ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for those who had asked us to remember them in our prayers, that the Lord our God may remember them according to his goodness at all times and forgive us our sins.
صلوا واطلبوا عن صعود مياه الأنهار في هذه السنة لكي يبارك المسيح إلهنا ويصعدها كمقدارها ويفرح وجه الأرض بالأنهار ويعولنا نحن البشر ويعطي النجاة لشعبه والبهائم ويرفع عن العالم الموت والغلاء والوباء والفناء والجلاء وسيف الأعداء ويجعل الهدوء والسلام والطمأنينة في البيعة المقدسة ويرفع شأن المسيحيين في كل مكان وفي كل المسكونة إلى النفس الأخير ويغفر لنا خطايانا. Let us pray and ask for this holy week of Pascha of our Savior, that he may complete it for us in peace and bring us the joy of his holy resurrection in safety and forgive us our sins.
خنتك متقورون
Yeah.
sabatrike yoke avyom nemo tikenin koi ke sosiona soniona Sabisiten ne chala oxeten mono hanainan kirielein son kirielein son kirie flogi son eminis moerois timatania kone kumbiesmo.
May Jesus Christ, our true God, who through his own goodwill accepted sufferings and was crucified on the cross for our sakes, bless us with all spiritual blessings and support us and complete for us the holy week of Pascha and bring forth us a joy of his holy resurrection for many years and peaceful times through the never-ending intercessions of the Immaculate Holy, the Lady Theotokos and Mary, and the choir of angels and archangels, through the prayers of the patriarchs, prophets, the apostles, the martyrs, the righteous, the holy ones, the cross bearers, the ascetics, the confessors, the anachorites, and the blessing of the holy week of Pascha of our good Savior, their holy blessing, the benediction, the power, the gift, the love, and their help be with us all forever. Amen. Per Christus Pinuti. ملك السلام أعطينا سلامك قرر لنا سلامك واغفر لنا خطايانا لك الملك والقوة والمجد إلى الأبد أمين. God make us worthy to pray thankfully. Our Father who art in heaven.
Be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven.